Earthing System. Introduction to Earthing. The voltage potential of the Earth is considered to be at zero for all practical purposes. Here, you can see an earth wire coming out of the building's electrical mains and is connected to an earthing electrode. The earth wire is normally green in color. The body of any electrical equipment is connected to the earth by means of a wire of negligible resistance to safely discharge electric energy, which may be due to a fault in the system. Earthing brings the potential of the body of the equipment to 0 volts, thus protecting the operating personnel against electrical shock. Families of Earthing. International Standard IEC 60364 distinguishes 3 families of earthing arrangements using the 2-letter codes TN, TT and IT. In a TN earthing system, one of the points in the generator or transformer is connected with earth, usually the star point in a 3-phase system. The body of the electrical device is connected with earth via this earth connection at the transformer. In a TT earthing system, the protective earth connection for the consumer is provided by a local earth electrode, and there is another independently installed at the generator. There is no earth wire between the two. The fault loop impedance is high. In an IT network, the electrical distribution system has no connection to earth at all, or it has only a high impedance connection. In such systems, an insulation monitoring device is used to monitor the impedance. Components of earthing system. A complete electrical earthing system consists of the following basic components: earth continuity conductor, earthing lid, earth electrode, whereas ground indicates actual earth. Switchboard indicates customer end contact. Methods of earthing. The earth resistance for copper wire is 1 ohm and that of galvanized iron wire is less than 3 ohm. The earth resistance should be kept as low as possible. The typical value of earth resistance is 0.5 to 1 ohm. Pipe earthing. Look at this design for details. A galvanized steel and a perforated pipe of length and diameter as shown in figure is placed vertically in a wet soil. It is the most common system of earthing. The size of pipe to use depends on the magnitude of current and the type of soil. The dimension of the pipe is usually 40 mm in diameter and 2.75 meter in length for ordinary soil or greater for dry and rocky soil. The moisture of the soil will determine the length of the pipe to be buried, but usually it should be 4.75 meter. Plate earthing. Look at this design for details. In plate earthing system, a plate made up of either copper with dimension 60 cm into 60 cm into 3.18 mm or galvanized iron of dimensions 60 cm into 60 cm into 6.35 mm is buried vertical in the earth, which should not be less than 3 meter from the ground level. Rod earthing. Look at this design for details. A copper rod of 12.5 mm or 16 mm diameter of galvanized steel of length above 2.5 meter are buried upright in the earth manually or using pneumatic hammer. The length of embedded electrodes in the soil reduces earth resistance to a desired value. Earth resistance. The resistance offered by the earth to the flow of current is known as earth resistance. The earth resistance is affected by the following factors: material properties of the earth wire and earth electrode, temperature inside earth pit, moisture content of the soil in earth pit, depth of the earth pit, quantity of the charcoal salt layer used inside earth pit, measurement of earth electrode resistance. The digital earth tester has four terminals. Short the terminals E1 and P1 and connect to the earth electrode E, whose resistance has to be found. Connect the P2 to the potential spike P and E2 to the current spike C. The distance between earth electrode and potential electrode is D1 and D2 is the distance between potential electrode and current electrode. These distances may range from 20 to 30 meters depending upon the soil. Turn the range selector switch to select a proper range for ohm. The digital display will come in action and will read 0. Now press the test switch. The LCD display will indicate the resistance. Measurement of earth resistivity. A four-terminal instrument is used to measure earth resistivity, which was developed by Dr. Frank Wenner in 1915. In this method, four separate rod type electrodes are used, that is termed as C1, P1, P2 and C2. These are connected to four terminals of the same name in the earth resistance tester using lead wires. A voltage V is applied across the P1 and P2 terminal, and the meter measures the current I flowing through C1 and C2. Using the value of V and I, the earth resistance is measured and displayed on the meter. Now, if the earth electrode depth B is kept small compared to the electrode gap distance between the electrodes A, the earth resistivity is given by P equal to 2 pi AR ohm centimeter. Here, A is electrode gap in centimeter and R is earth resistance in ohms. That's all for earthing system.